Welcome back to The Last Door. Season 2, Episode 3, The Reunion, has just come out. So, let's jump right into it. For 3 days, you must wait. Alone amongst these dead stones. Only then will you be ready. Complete your journey, Mr. Ashdown. I think I can remember. It's terrible screech. But it was not that of an animal. There was something human in it. A desperate cry for forgiveness. They found me on the beach, unconscious, clutching the piece of wood that has saved me from drowning. When at last I awoke, the letter was waiting on my table. Lieber Wakefield, I write this letter in my last moments of lucidity. I have not received word from you since I regained consciousness, but I am confident that you will soon return with information that is crucial to our investigation. The bravery that you demonstrated in the face of these latest discoveries is worthy of my most sincere admiration. I must now ask you for yet more courage. The doctors were unable to determine the cause of my sudden illness, nor have they found a cure. I have not much time left. My greatest regret is that I must abandon you to the difficult tasks that lie ahead. I implore you to persevere now that we are so close to finding an answer. The professor's documents were filled with references to a place of dark legend, the Crone Maiden, an ancient sanctuary on the island of Ellismore. The exact location of the Crone Maiden has been lost, but the professor believed that its secrets may explain why his experiments met with such disastrous results. You must find this place, mein Freund. I do not need to remind you to exercise the uttermost discretion. I have complete trust in you. Always your friend, Johann Kaufmann. With Kaufmann gone, I found myself lost, my life suddenly devoid of meaning. It was as though my friend had written a letter to a person who no longer existed. Weeks passed, maybe months. I did not count the time. But the day came when I realized there was no other option. To honor my friend's memory, I had to keep looking. I had to find Jeremiah Devitt. Wherever he was. I can see the island in the distance. Ellismore. And yes, I know I'm probably totally mispronouncing that. I know there's little symbols above the E and the O and the I, and it's probably Ellismore, Moore or something. I don't know. But instead of trying to make it sound fancy and getting it wrong, I'm just going to get it so wrong that it's obvious. Ellismore is what I'm going to call it. Here we are, the island of Ellismore. Wait. I thought that was E-L-L-I-S. It's E-I-L-I-S? Ellismore? I'm confused. Well, whatever. We arrived at an island. Thank you very much. It is E-I-L-I-S. In that case, Ellismore? I'm gonna go with Ellismore. According to Kaufmann's letter, the legendary Crone Maiden can be found here. As Kaufmann emphasized, I must exercise discretion. For all I know, the playwright is watching. Alright, there we go. Seems like we're through the introduction and we've arrived at the meat of this episode. That was a great beginning. That was a really good beginning. This series just continues to surprise me. The sound design was so good, and it's just, I don't know, it just flowed really well, you know? It wasn't just, you know, it was only partially interactive, that beginning section, but it was interactive enough to feel like it's not just a cutscene. It was really cool, you know? I got to move around, and I got to actually kind of initiate, like, the next part of the I guess, like, sort of a montage of different things that it uses at the beginning of this episode to set the storyline up, but it did such a good job of setting the storyline up while still allowing me to play in such a, you know, such a more interesting way than just a cutscene where you have no interactivity. It's just so cool, and the sound was so good! Oh, the scrape of the chalk on the ground. Oh, that was so perfect. This series is just... I love this game series. It's really good. Even though the puzzles can sometimes be bleh. It's also really, really good. Good evening. Visiting? I hope you enjoy your stay. Oh, thank you. I wonder how big this island is. Seems very... You know what? I was about to say something incredibly dumb. I'm just gonna put that thought in the recycling bin and throw it away. Yep, there we go. Dump the trash. Let's not even say that out loud. Stupid brain. Good evening. My name is Wakefield. I've just arrived on the island. You ought to speak with Lord Donnan, then. Oh god, is this whole place going to be filled with people that have names I can't pronounce properly? I beg your pardon? Lord Donnan, you should see him. Okay, fair enough. Good evening. Welcome to Eyeless Moor. Well, the locals seem pretty friendly. You look like a drunkard. Excuse me? A visitor! Visitors are most welcome in Eyeless Moor. Yes, they are. Is it because you want to use our bodies for ritual sacrifices? Is that why you're so friendly? This gate looks like it's just been blown off. Looks like the gate's been broken for some time now, yeah. Don't worry about it, it was probably just a moderate-sized Cthulhu just roaming around here. It happens. The Wisdom of Silence. I don't know if being silent so much means you're wise, so much as you just don't display your ignorance. Which, not displaying your ignorance can be wise in and of itself, so, yeah, okay. Fair enough. The windows are open and the light is on. An abandoned wheel. A peculiar cog is attached to it. Based on the cog's workmanship, it looks like it was part of a complex industrial mechanism, but someone has tried to fit it crudely onto that broken bicycle wheel. How on earth did it come to be in a village like this? That's bizarre. Industrial cogwheel that I found lying discarded in the village. Yeah, why is it on a bike wheel? Door's locked. Of course it is. So clearly I have to use the cog on the window to break it. Oh wait, it's already open. Can I just crawl through the window? No, okay. This is too hard, I need to walk through. Help! Can I, like, knock on the door? I mean, all he's trying to do is open the door. Why not knock to get somebody's attention? Excuse me, are you Mr. Wakefield? I am. I have a message from Lord Donnan. Lord Donnan? To our most recent visitor, Mr. Wakefield. It is customary in Eyeless Moor to welcome strangers with hospitality. I should be honored if you would accept this invitation to join me at my manor for dinner and amiable conversation. Your new friend, Lord Donnan. Your new friend. You haven't even met me and you're calling me your friend. That's so much hospitality, it's actually pretty creepy, and now I'm starting to even believe my own random thought that maybe they're so hospitable to strangers because they want their bodies for a ritual sacrifice. What are these flags about? A faint smell of fish and potatoes is drifting through the shutter. The fish smells slightly rotten. Ugh. The gate leads to the village graveyard. It is closed and locked. Good. I don't think I want to visit the graveyard. Alright, let's head over to our new friend. Oh my god, this manor. Beautiful. Well, Dr. Wakefield, you're here on holiday, then? Yes, indeed. I've come to enjoy a rest somewhere far from the stresses of city life. Alright, so keeping it cool. Don't want to let the locals know what I'm doing here. I see. Well, if it's distractions you've come looking for, you've chosen the right time of year for it. These days, we celebrate a very special tradition of our kin. Something unique. We call it the Festival of Reunion. There's totally gonna be ritual killings. Fascinating. May I ask, what does it entail? According to tradition, for the next 3 nights, the spirits of Reunion leave the confines of the Other Side and roam the hills of Eyeless Moor. We wear costumes and masks so that the spirits will not recognize us and make us the targets of their mischief. Certain rites take place, too. Like ritual sacrifice rites. But I should not bore you with the details. You shall have occasion to see for yourself. Oh my god, I'm totally gonna get ritual sacrificed. I'm dead. I mean, I'm already dead. Like, there's not even any point in doing anything. I'm dead. I'm dead. Just kill me now. An exotic blend of black tea. That sounds really, really good. I just bought a pound of loose leaf Irish breakfast tea, and it's damn good. A large statue of a person. It is so eroded by the passage of time, it is difficult to tell any specific detail. An odd mosaic adorns the floor. It depicts two snakes biting each other. There are two engraved panels on the wall. They appear to be ancient, but I cannot decipher their meaning. Do these panels on the wall represent a classical theme? I cannot seem to place it. They're the panels of the first king of Eyeless Moor. In the days of the Druids, we worship the great god Lu, and our kings did right by those beliefs. Well, I cannot help noticing this remarkable mosaic. It looks authentic. Yes, it is. Although some historians might disagree, we believe that this manor was built atop an ancient Roman villa. In our traditions, the double serpent represents a sentinel that protects us from the terrible threat hidden within itself. The statue is remarkable. May I ask what it represents? It is Lu Lamphara, a hero and high king of our myths. You seem to be knowledgeable about Eyeless Moor's folklore. I should very much like to learn about the island's history in more detail. It is true that we in Eyeless Moor cleave to the ancient traditions. We haven't lost touch like some of those on the mainland, but I'm no expert. If you are really interested, you should talk to Miss Foster. Please forgive my indiscretion, but do you consider yourself a religious man, Dr. Wakefield? I've actually got a choice here. Alright, well, I'm not even thinking about answering this honestly, because I'm obviously just playing a role here, and I don't want them to let on. So... So which option is the most strategically sound? Which one would make me the least suspicious, or maybe the least likely to get ritually sacrificed? Honestly, I don't know. I'm gonna say no. No, I do not. You seem so certain. Might I ask why? I have not yet found a religion that provides the answers I seek. I see. Let us take a walk by the lake. From there we can see the beauty of the island as we talk, and be the better for it. The marsh in this valley is, for simpletons, a wellspring of frightful tales. The educated among us enjoy the tales as little more than distractions, knowing us safe from those visions. We know these stories to be nothing but superstition. But how can we be so sure that in the dense mist that emanates from the stagnant water, we may not find passages to other worlds? What if the wails that drift from the reeds in the darkest of nights are the songs of those from our worst nightmares? Okay, this is taking a dark turn. Many of the gods that men worship for millennia now lie buried in the common grave of oblivion. In Eyeless Moor, we keep our traditions alive. Oh, they change, just as the times do. But they always keep their essence. These are our roots, Doctor. I must now take my leave, as my presence is required to start the rites of reunion. Feel free to continue your walk on your own. The village can be found just beyond those hills. As I mentioned earlier, you may wish to speak with Miss Foster. She is something of a resident expert on Eyeless Moor's history. She can often be found working late at the school, the building right across from the quay. It has been a pleasure meeting you. Farewell, Dr. Wakefield. It has been a pleasure, Lord Donnan. The waters of the marsh is murky and dark. Or, sorry, not plural. The water of the marsh is murky and dark. An old barrel lies stranded on the shore. It is sealed, and the paint used to label its contents has peeled off long ago. It's sealed. So I don't know what's in it, and it's sealed. That sounds like maybe eventually I'll be able to open it. Gotta keep that in mind. Okay, let's leave. Somebody... Oh, it's gotta be because of the festival, basically, happening. Why that person's wearing such a strange outfit. Where did I come from? Did I come from here? I'm trying to figure out where I came from before I do anything else. I guess I just came from back there. Broken old fence. Yeah, I came from back there. Excuse me. Excuse me. Hello, my name is Wakefield. Hi. Oh, at least this one talks to me. What are you drawing on the ground? It's a symbol, not a drawing. A symbol? What does it mean? It's the final truth that'll protect us from the marsh dwellers. But we're not allowed to say its name out loud. The marsh dwellers? Who are they? They're scary. My Aunt Kathleen says they were real bad people. You'd never see them, but you'd hear them in the reeds. They try to take you in there with them. That's why we can't come here alone. We always have to take someone with us. I must go now. Goodbye. Farewell. That's an awkward end of the conversation. Alright, so that would be the so-called simpletons, in the words of Lord Donnan. The people that believe in the superstitious tales, which, given what I've seen so far in this game, is probably not superstition entirely. What is that? Alright, this is some sort of Stonehenge-y type thing with a massive cavernous hole in the ground. Jesus. A huge hole lies in front of me. An ominous, chilling draft issues from within that sends shivers down my spine and makes me very uneasy. To a superstitious mind, it might seem like a passage to another world. What is that sound? It sounds like there's a massive beast groaning down there, waiting for people to just fall in or be pushed in. This place appears to be the remnants of an ancient temple to some unknown deity. Actually, hold on. Can I talk to you about what that is up there? Nope. You want to talk to me? Nope. You want this cog? Nope. Gotta cover all my bases. This should go back to the water, right? Yep. Okay. Let's see if we can find this expert in local history and traditions. Oh god, the graveyard's open. Great. I really want to know what these flags are about. A small mausoleum. The door has a small slot. I might be able to peer through it. I shouldn't have looked in the small slot. Inside, a candle provides dim light. I can make out a statue of a hooded man. I can also hear some whispering. No, I can't die yet. Not without knowledge. Is it so terribly unthinkable to truly understand the gods? How can we live only on faith? No, shut up. Knowledge is what I pursue, not faith nor assumptions. No, no man can face death believing there is nothing on the other side. Yes, you are right. Now I understand. I just heard one side of a conversation. I want to know what the other side of the conversation was. Can I hear any more? No? The epitaph on this gravestone is written in Gaelic, the shadows cast by the lanterns only making the characters more mysterious. Okay, bunch of people in creepy masks standing around some graves. Nothing strange about that. The man hides his face behind a fox mask. He murmurs something in unison with the others, a muted prayer I cannot quite make out. I believe they're burying mirrors in a hole in the ground. What a peculiar tradition. Should I try to talk to any of them? I feel like I'm interrupting. In the middle of the graveyard stands an old alder tree, which the locals call a fearnog. Many lanterns hang from it. I do not know for what purpose. See, woman hides her face behind a bull mask. Man, face hidden by wolf masks. Wait, it says there is something familiar about him. I've seen him before. The person in the boat, somebody from the town, the Lord himself. Hidden behind a deer mask. Badger mask. Wait, what's in here? Oh, that's probably the woman that knows all about local history. Before we go talk to her, what is back here? An empty doghouse. Nothing has slept here in many years. An old rowboat filled with stale water. That's so cool, you can even see your own reflection in the water. A worn-out umbrella. It doesn't look like it will rain anytime soon, but there might be a purpose for it. The water is so muddy that I can barely see the bottom of the trough. Oh, it leads back here. Okay. Well, let's go talk to the woman. Trash ban filled with papers? Did I say trash ban? I think I was trying to say trash bin and can at the same time. Let's try that again. A trash bin filled with papers. There's a drawing on one. It's a child's drawing. There seems to be a village, a lake, and some sort of creature. Yeah, that would appear to be a dragon or some sort of dragon-like creature, burning down a house. Don't know what I'm gonna do with that. The windows are open, letting a chilly draft inside. Good evening. To what do I owe the pleasure? I'm a busy woman, as you can see. My name is Dr. Wakefield. I've come to Eyeless Moor to rest for a while. Lord Donnan said that I might find you here. Have you met Lord Donnan? It has been so long since I have seen him here in the village. I hope he is well. I am not even gonna try to say that. Or am I? I don't even know how to make the... What even is the sound for the... What is the little thing over the E and the A and stuff do? What is... How does that modify the sound of it? I don't even know. I'm sorry. Seed Mele... okay. Dr. Wayfield, welcome to Eyeless Moore. I'm never gonna try that again. I'm probably gonna try it again. So you have not seen Lord Donnan lately? As far as I know, no one has seen him since... Well, it's been a few weeks. Now that the festival has started, maybe he'll be motivated to join us in the village. Did something happen a few weeks ago? Oh, sure. It was only terrible. Kieran, his only child, disappeared without a trace. He went off to play in the hills and just... vanished. No one has seen him since. He vanished in the hills. He wouldn't have happened to have been playing near the giant gaping hole. Would he? Because if he did, I think I know where he went. Good lord. And you say he has not been found yet. How is that possible? We all searched the island, but he was nowhere to be found. What can you tell me about Kieran's disappearance? Just that he was a restless child who loved exploring deserted areas. You might learn more from his classmates. He totally fell down the hole. A restless child who loved exploring deserted areas. Playing in the hills. And up in the hills, I found a giant gaping hole in the ground. He totally fell in the hole. His desk was in the back corner. What can you tell me about this curious festival? Well, it takes place when the constellation Reunion is visible in the sky. On those nights, dark things and spirits ride the winds that travel across the hills. As you may have already seen, at sunset, the villagers don masks. They do this so that the spirits will not know them, or carry them away to the depths of their underground caves. There's a group of masked people at the graveyard. Was that part of the festival? Yes, that was one of the first rites of the reunion, a very important one. As I said, people dress up to protect themselves from those that will come. But this is not enough. Since the mirrors they have looked into while changing know their identities, they buried them next to the old Fearnog. The roots of this tree grow in both worlds at the same time, so they keep the witness mirrors safe. Oh, okay, so that's why they were burying the mirrors. Lord Donnan said you are an expert on the island's folklore. He said that, did he? Well, I wouldn't call myself an expert now, but I've lived here in Eyeless Moor longer than most, and I've heard my fair share of stories about the other side and its people. Might I ask you a question, Miss Foster? Yes, of course. Do you know the meaning of the word Crone Maiden? Uh-oh. Should I be asking about this? I might be showing my hand here. Oh well, I can't undo it now. Yes, it's a very unusual word. Very much indeed. The Crone Maiden is the sanctuary of the Crooked One. It is a cursed place, the dwelling of the devil. I recall it from the tales that I heard as a child. Of course, our elders only made up those tales to scare us and protect us from harm. Would you tell me the story of the Crone Maiden? All right. There's a hole in the ground up in the hills, not too far from the village. A hole so dark and deep, you'd not see the end. Folks around here believe there lies an old serpent at its depths, ravenous for flesh. The Crooked One. Long ago, our ancestors threw livestock into the pit in the hope of placating their Crooked One's hunger. Though that tradition has not been practiced for some time, so perhaps it would be best if you did not approach the hole. It is said that the last heir of the Laidsend once defied the Crooked One by approaching the rim with an iron amulet in her hand. It is general knowledge that beings from the other side detest iron, so the cursing and the shouting of the young Laidsin received no immediate answer. But a few nights later, the Laidsin house was consumed in a horrific blaze, putting an end to the old family. Oh, that's gotta be the child drawing. The child's drawing showed, like a dragon or something burning down a house. So that's gotta be the horrific blaze. So I guess that's the child's interpretation of the old story. I must leave now. It has been a pleasure. The pleasure was mine. Enjoy your time on Eyeless Moor. She seems nice. She's probably gonna murder me later. Okay, well, after having just talked to her, I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode. Alright, so we've arrived at this strange island, learned about their strange traditions, and learned that there's, of course, as always for this game series, creepy stuff going on. There's always creepy stuff. You know, rituals and holes in the ground and beings from other sides and crows, and there's always something going on. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm going to find some more information about Kieran, and I guess probably see if I can find him.